Imagine if there was a woman who entered paradise because of her kindness to an animal. Imagine a man who entered paradise or who was forgiven his sins because of his kindness to a dog. Well, I think I could do a little bit better than that, inshallah, isn't it? Isn't it? But the question is, we don't know what other bad deeds they had when we have a lot of bad deeds. That's the thing. You might be kind to a dog and to your cat at home, but to your daughter-in-law, you're a monster. Can happen. Or the other way, to your mother-in-law, you're a monster. It can happen both ways, because sometimes daughters-in-law enter the home already with a preconceived idea. This is a Chinese vehicle, it's not going to work. This is a Chinese vehicle, it's not going to work. This is a Chinese... Please don't say that. That's embarrassing. It's a vehicle. It will take you from A to B. And China is spelt with C. My brothers, that's just an example. Come on, don't take it too seriously. No, nothing personal. I know the vehicles are doing their way. They look so beautiful and tremendous. But to be honest with you, the example I'm giving is when you go in with a preconceived idea, you don't even know what it's all about. Not at all. So sometimes people are bad in a relationship, not because the other person's bad, because they went in already like they want to play rugby, man. Subhanallah, you already got your sleeves up, you're looking, and you just entered the house. Allahu Akbar. May Allah grant us ease. This is what's happening, my brothers, my sisters. May Allah grant us goodness. So sometimes we are kind to our cats, but we're not kind to our parents. Sometimes we are kind to our dogs, but we are not kind to our brothers and sisters. Sometimes we are kind to our monkeys, but we are not kind to our family members. Imagine. You look, you spend hours on end, you know, mashallah, with your cat, and you take it here and there, and you, subhanallah, a little cat gets lost, and that's qiyamah for you. And so, mashallah, with all due respect to our pets, may Allah grant us acceptance, and may Allah make it easy for all of us. But who's more important? Islam gives importance to both animals and humans, but tells you, start with the human being, then you extend to the animals. If two are drowning, a dog is drowning and a human being is drowning, who would you save? I hear someone saying human. Someone said both. That's the right answer. I would save both, but I am asked to start with one and then the other. Which one do I start with? The human. When I start with a human being, I dive in, I save the human. My intention is, inshallah, I'll put the human aside and then I'm going to go for the dog. Subhanallah. And then you save the dog. If you got both, alhamdulillah. If you got one, still you save the human being. It's okay. Sometimes we give preference over the dog. There was someone who told me, well, if it's my mother-in-law, I'll start with the other one. But don't do that. Not at all. Not at all. No way. My brothers, my sisters, may Allah grant us love and mahabba in our homes.